We'll deal with race. We'll deal with the economy. So the challenge is, where is your faith? Jesus said, if you got faith, then you got to do something with it. James said, faith without works, it's just that you ain't got none. So they come to church, they say, where have I got faith? Oh, hallelujah, that's me. I'm telling you, they don't start speaking in tongues. But James said, that's good. But what you doing with your faith? Is it just something you put in your container, say, and you put a label on, that's faith? But God, they say that this faith that you have ought to do something, ought to transform something, ought to produce something. I'm almost on your way. Six of you have turned me off. That he said, what I like about this portion of scripture, he gave some examples of how people before us were in the annals of faith walkers. You can pray with me that. That he put some people in this list who I think shouldn't be in the list, but who am I? Who? But thank God he put some of them in the list, because if they can make it, maybe there's hope for me. That I look at this list of faith walkers and I got tired and stopped at the seventh verse, but maybe someday if God would give me the grace, that someone will tell the story of a faith walker that walked by faith and not by sight. That walked until he was, let me leave that alone. That he says, by faith, Abel was able to offer to God a more excellent sacrifice than Cain, through which he obtained a witness that he was righteous. God testified of his gift, and through it, he being dead, still speaks. Saints, my time is gone. But let me say this to you. I've wrestled with the Cain and Abel story. I'm a preacher. Let me be real with you. I wonder why God was selective in the offering. Get me scared, you know, because all of us offer the same thing at offering. But it seems that God accepts some offering and rejects. That frightens me. That frightens me. And so I ask God, I see you a glass dimly, just a little bit. Show me a little bit of why you operated like this. And then you just did not take it. You took Cain off the scene. Because you didn't want that spirit loose into that. Hallelujah. You didn't want that spirit loose into that spirit. Why, God, would you accept an Abel offering? But will not accept a Cain offering. And it wasn't until I looked at the book of Leviticus and saw the prescribed order of the offering that I saw that there was an offering God was requiring. But you see, Cain decided to give God what he feel like giving God. I feel all right in this place. That God said that you ought to bring me a sacrifice, a living sacrifice. He said, yeah, take some of this Cain. I need my sheep. You asking for too much. You know, when you go to church, they always ask him, take what I give you, God. And God said, it don't go so. God said, enter my gates with thanksgiving. Some of you came with a Cain spirit. You tell God, take what I give you. I feel all right in this place. God said, I gave you bread. That said, it ain't come on. I'll take it away. He said, I'll cause the rocks to cry out for me. That you've got to get to the place. You better do what God asks you to do. If God said to enter with thanksgiving, give him what he asks for. Don't come with a Cain sacrifice. Don't mess with God. My mama used to say, your hand's too short to box with God. And we reach to a place where we tell God, take it or leave it. God said, I can fix your business. No power. Church full of people. No power. Why? Because you're in Burger King. You want it your way. God said, whenever you decide to do it my way, power, 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 power. Say, you should walk on scorpions and they should do you no harm. Do it my way. Do it. Do it my way. It's too much. pain in this life. There's too much pain in this life. We want something for nothing. God said it's a sacrifice. It ought to cost you something. It ought to be hurting. It ought to be too much cheapness. We play God cheap. But God is bigger than your little sacrifice. He's just testing you. He's just testing you. And so the challenge is that some of us have reached a place where we don't want to do what God has told us to do. And I'm done. The challenge with that is when you don't do what God tells you to do, you don't get what God has for you. Don't get upset with me, take it up with the Jesus. I'm just the messenger this morning. That some of you walking around, why he ain't blessing me? That's a simple thing. You've decided not to do it God's way. And because you've decided not to, God said, I don't have to confuse them. I don't have, he said, stay in darkness. He said, the power is available to you, but you've got to decide to walk in my authority. Let me see if I can give you an example. God says to Elijah the prophet, said, Elijah, take stuff in Nassau. And what I need you to do, I need you to go downtown. I need you to tell him, until we get this house in order, there'll be no rain until I return. And they looked and said, how dare you? But you broke preacher's house. Come down here and declare in parliament there'll be no rain? Who you think you is? And you know his wife Lucia? Say, boy, you need to put something on him. What you need to do is find him and let's wipe him out. So the prophet had to run for his life. The man and woman of God went into hiding because they were afraid of what man will do. God dried up the brook. A place of supernatural provision. He dried up tourism. A place of supernatural provision. And he said, if you can move any further, you better come to me. And he said, don't stay to a place I've shut down. I've commanded a Shilohite widow to sustain you. Watch the words. I've commanded her. I've spoken over her to sustain what I've assigned for you. I feel his presence in this place. That her blessing is connected to the assignment that's on your life. And what I need you to do is get up from this dried up brook and start to walk towards a place of command blessing. Now here's the problem. God can speak over you and you don't know. Heaven is having a conversation about you and you don't know. I wish I had some things I'll fly all over this place that heaven has promotion, has deliverance, has prosperity on her, but it looked like problem. So the prophet shows up. Now, here's what you must get. The prophet is operating into a mantle that he's communicating with God face to face. I don't know. I didn't tell you, but I don't know if he was a face to face prophet, but he's communicating with God. And as he's communicating with God, God gives him the written mandate. How does it work? Because I'll do nothing in the earth unless I reveal it to my prophet. So he didn't necessarily talk to her, but he got a command blessing on her. And it's up to her. Watch this now. This is every New Testament. It's up to her what happens next. Prophet shows up. Say, how you doing? She said, everything is fine. Say, you got any water? in the middle of that quarter. And so she ran and tell her son, get that water for the preacher. Get that water for the preacher. Preacher thirsty. She had no problem with me drinking the water. There's plenty of water. You know, let's just say, no, that's not. He asked for dollar, give him dollar. She even asked, you want some more water? She said, you want to go get some? If it costs us nothing, we're happy to do it. If it costs us nothing, we'll give it to you freely. Now, I can't drink the water. What was it? You got any food? She said, yeah, I got a little bit here. And she started that back and stuff. But you see, Rev? Let me tell you what happened. I only got this little bit. You know, it's all I got. This is it. I come to church and there's one $10. I leave $100 in the church. That's all I got. See, look at my back. That's all I bring to church. You hear what I got? That's all I bring to church. The prophet in his audacity puts a demand on our resources. And he says, go make a meal for me. Make me a cake. Bring it in your hand. And let me eat that first. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Stay with me, man. It's easy to give me water, but to watch me eat your cake, your last piece of cake. You think I ever tell you the baby? This is mine. I know why God sent me here. I wouldn't know what cake tastes like if I didn't stop by here. My God. He must be the best baker in the best food. This cake is good. Your wife loves your mother. This cake is good. And her spirit of giving turned into wax.
Yeah.
I wonder when imagine when she's taking out her breath. Maybe he all. No good preachers. Driving these nice cars. Ask some people for dollars. They should be giving me dollars. See, ain't no one to say nothing yet. I'm going to tell you, child. I got passed by again. And this piece of paper. This turns. I'm going to blow up. Even the water tastes good. That's what blasts out. The prophet eats. She's getting besides herself. Because she's watching her resources. Depleted, giving to a stranger. The prophet turns around and now declares what God has already said. But it was up to her. He said, daughter, your well will never run dry. Your power will never run out of food. As long as you make a demand on it, it shall produce. I'm gonna need you a prophetic reward. Thank you. That he declares what God has already. She would have never gotten that declaration if she didn't cut on the faith switch. And some of us, God is saying, don't jump. It looked like you're down to your last, but heaven ain't run over the last time I checked. That when God makes a demand,